In today's episode, we are going to learn all about Coco Peat, what it is, how to use it in gardening, and what are the pros and cons of using Coco Peat as potting media. Hopefully, by end of the video, your doubts regarding Coco Peat will be cleared. So do watch the entire video without skipping it. Coco peat or coconut coir is made from fiber-like material present in between solid inner and outer shell of a coconut. Earlier, it was considered as a waste product until people learned to use it in many ways for gardening as well as in various household products. Coco peat is often found in compressed and compact brick-like structure, which can be broken down easily by adding adequate water to it. Other types of coco coir, like coco fibers and coco chips, which are small chunks, are also available to use in gardening. This is a 5 kg coco brick I am using here. The brick will need to be reconstituted before using, and I will show how to do that in this video. Take a large bucket and put the brick inside it. Add enough water to saturate the coco brick. Allow the brick to sit in the water for some time so that it can gradually absorb the water and become loose. Continue to add more water until it becomes loose and properly moistened. The brick will expand and increase up to 5 to 6 times in volume after absorbing the water. If needed, stir and flap it. Here I have used only half of the 5 kg block and saved the rest for later use. You can rinse off the excess amount of water and keep the coco peat in a separate place. This will allow it to dry off quickly. Once you see the moist and loose coco peat, it is now ready to use in gardening. We shall now take a look at what are the uses of coco peat in gardening. It can be directly incorporated into the garden soil to improve water retention, aeration, and decrease the risk of the fungal attack in soil and root-borne diseases. Mix one part of coco peat with 3 parts of garden soil for better results. It can also be used as a mulching around garden plants to help the soil remain moist and prevent the growth of weeds. In container gardening, it can be used as an excellent soil-less growing medium for plants. Add 5 parts of coco peat with 3 parts of organic compost like vermicompost and 2 parts of vermiculite and perlite or sand for better results in pot culture. You can also apply a 1 inch layer of coco peat over the container soil to help the soil remain moist. Additionally, coco peat can also be used as an excellent hydroponic medium or in aquaculture growing environments. Coco peat can be used as a soil growing medium for starting seeds. Once the shoot starts to form, you can transplant the seedling into your regular pots. We shall now take a look at the advantages of Coco Pith. It is extremely effective for water retention. In fact, it can actually hold up to 10 times of its weight in water. Coco Pith also offers reliable drainage and ideal aeration, giving the roots of your plant plenty of room and allowing for optimum air exposure. Thus, it can promote a massive and healthy root development very quickly and at very early stages of your plant. Another thing is that the pH value of Coco Pith is neutral to slightly acidic, 5.2 to 6.8, and is thus very beneficial for plants compared to the usual sphagnum peat moss. Coco Pith also consists of 75% carbohydrates and 25% lignin, which is a complex organic polymer which create perfect breeding ground for microorganisms and beneficial bacteria. And at the same time, it also discourages the growth of harmful bacteria and fungus in your potting mix, and thus making it truly pathogen-free. Coco Pith also contains significant amount of natural phosphorus and potassium, which are essential for plants' root development, flowering, and overall metabolism. Coco Pith is completely organic and thus has no harmful effect on the environment. It is physically very stable and can only disintegrate very slowly, making it reusable and recyclable up to several years. Now coming to the drawbacks or disadvantages of Coco Pith. It has very few drawbacks compared to its numerous advantages. The first drawback is its lack of adequate nutrients compared to the regular garden soil, and that's why you will need to maintain a frequent or regular fertilization while using coconut coir as your potting media. Another drawback would be due to its high porosity and very lightweight, so that the potting mix containing a very high amount of Coco Pith might not support the weight of a big plant or medium-sized plant during very windy day. Finally, serious problem might come from due to the overwatering in Coco Pith media. Roots going in waterlogged media may die due to lack of oxygen they needed. And as the Coco Pith retain more water compared to your regular soil, the drainage system in your container should be proper while using Coco Pith. You should add adequate perlite or sand in potting mix to make it well draining. Finally, once you understand the nature of proper nutrient requirements of Coco Pith, it can put into use in almost all areas in gardening, such as in horticulture, in floriculture, greenhouse, seedling nurseries, worm bedding, hydroponics growing medium, and various other things. And that's why Coco Pith is getting more and more popular among the modern gardeners. Thank you for watching, and see you again.